of the Nigerian Electricity Market Stabilization Facility. If you remember very well, after the privatization in late 2013, when it took over, 2013 or 2014, the DISCOs and the GENCOs, all they were complaining was that they don't have money, that the market was not, there was illiquidity in the market, of course they are not flowing in. There were legacy gas debts. They also complained MDAs were owing them a lot of money. So to improve liquidity in the system, the Central Bank of Nigeria designated a 213 billion naira facility to be assessed by DISCO, distribution companies, generation companies across the value chain of the Nigerian electricity market, so as to reduce the challenge of the liquidity challenge and then pay off legacy debts and allow these companies to now have resources to begin to invest in improving whether it's the distribution or the generating chain of the electricity market. If you look at page 2 to page 3 to page 4, running up to page 6, you have the terms and conditions for assessing the fund by electricity companies who operate in the Nigerian electricity market. These are the terms and conditions of how they could assess the fund. Now, if you go to page 6, we now talk about the disbursement of the fund proper. You will see the companies that benefited and the quantum of resources that was so far disbursed. So the total sum disbursed before the CBN like call it off was 120.2 billion. You could see companies like Eco Electricity Distribution Company, Ibadan Distribution Company, Jeba Hydroelectricity PLC, Kenji Hydroelectricity PLC, Chiroro, the Enugu Disco, Ibadan Disco, Ugeli Electricity Generation Company, Ibadan. They all benefited. But CBN stopped at 120.2 billion out of the 213 billion that was earmarked. Because at some point, the companies that were being helped, more or less said they were no longer, either they were no longer interested or they were no longer in a position to take the money and pay back. Because I recall when we had a review of this book earlier, one of the discos was here. The way they presented it was like it was even of no use to them. It's not like the central bank held them. So the question was, why did you agree that they should take money in the first place? We knew that these people did not have the three components of capacities that you need to have to be core investors. They did not have the financial capacity to take over these companies. They went and borrowed money from banks to take over these discos and GENCOs. So, and they secured these loans with the properties of these companies, which ideally should is wrong, which wasn't theirs at the beginning. So all the money they generated in terms of tariffs, these banks were collecting it. So they borrowed money to acquire the property. They didn't have money of their own. And the banks were unwilling to give them more funds to improve the properties because they had not paid back the ones they got. So if you look at the results, we looked at the power situation in terms of power generated and wheeled out and gets to the discos, pre the loans, and looked at what has happened post the loans, and we couldn't see any change. Rather, the situation was worsening. If you look at table 1 on page 8, you see what happened within the period for the first quarter of 2016. The system operator wheeled electricity worth 8.6 billion to the discos in January 2016, and gave them the invoice, and they were only able to bring back 30 billion, which is 35%. In February, they were given electricity worth 7.8 billion, they brought back 3.2, 40.9%. In March, they were given 7.4 billion worth of electricity, they brought back 2.4. So, averagely for the 3 months, they were bringing back 36.24% of the invoice they were given.